I referred her to sceptres and thrones, and I accounted wealth as nothing in comparison with her. Neither did I liken her to any priceless treasure, because all gold is but a plain sand in her sight, and silver will be counted as clay before. I loved her more than health and beauty, and I chose her to have rather than light, because her radiance never ceases. All good things came to me along with her, and in her hands uncounted wealth. I rejoiced in them all because wisdom needs them, but I did not know that she was their mother. I learned without guile, and I impart without grudging. I do not hide her wealth, for it is an unfailing treasure from them. Those who get it obtain friendship with God, commended for the gifts that come from instruction.
does bear fruit, he proves that it may bear more fruit. You are already made clean by the words which I have spoken to you. Abide in me, and I in you. As the branch cannot bear fruit by itself, unless it abides in the vine, neither can you unless you abide in me. I am the vine, you are the branches. He who abides in me, and I in him, he it is that bears much fruit. For apart from me, you can do nothing. If a man does not abide in me, he is cast forth as a branch and withers. And the branches are gathered and thrown into the fire and burned. If you abide in me, and my words abide in you, ask whatever you will, and it shall be done for you. By this my Father is glorified, that you bear much fruit, and so prove to be my disciples.
The Gospel of the Lord.
Guns as they passed by on lodged with a Florentine merchant who paid his rent by giving them, tutoring them in Latin and Greek, and led a withdrawn life. It's only later that he gathered around himself the group of followers, first as a layman to tend pilgrims and also to look after convalescents who often, when they left the hospitals, had lapses in the The story goes on those long years of the pilgrimages to the seven churches, the daily exercises of the oratory, the preaching, having to endure attacks and criticisms. The oratory was very nearly suppressed under the Dominican Pope Pius V for heresy. Cheerfully carried on, trying to do God's will. He's called the saint of Christian joy because he never allowed anything to incommode him in the slightest degree. Some of his subjects were unbelievably rude to him. One young man snatched a letter out of his hand because he thought criticism of him. Everyone was amazed that Philip's countenance never changed, but just carried on as usual. There's a lot to be said for carrying on as usual. He wouldn't let young men or young women change their state of life, even if it was for something better, unless they about it for a long time. He ended up sending many to convents and monasteries, but he had to make absolutely sure that it was God's will for them. The Pope insisted that for the last 10 years of his life he went to live at the Chiesa Nuova, the new church they built in the parish that the Pope gave them. But he was still attached to his just on, almost on the roof at St. Jeremy's San Geronimo de la Carita, where he built the first little oratory for his followers to pray together, to read and to study together each afternoon. He was a practical joker, and for the serious or pompous, that would be a great burden. Send two of the community every day to feed the cat. When they got back, especially if there was a cardinal or a prince present, he said, "How was Pussy today? Did she enjoy her dinner?" They were horrified. He used to make the more elegant young men carry his dog Capriccio. In other words, he did what he wanted to do, but it was a big dog. They had to walk down the wall, so holding this wretched balloonless mutt in their arms, soiling their beautiful doublets and their ruffs. I don't think he would have been an easy person to live with, and yet he was deeply loved. We can make the feast a day early, as it were, because tomorrow is Ascension Day. Don't worry if you come hoping to fulfill your Ascension Day obligation tonight, but it is the Mass of Ascension. Indeed, I must point out that until next year, Ascension Day isn't the only day of obligation, because there aren't any. So don't go into a collapse at the thought of not being able to get to Mass for Ascension Day. Bishop of Hexham in Newcastle said, "They're very good, your choir, aren't they?" "But they're excellent, especially their great child. called by bells, I better stop, haven't I? On the 25th of May, in the year of his death, that happened to be Corpus Christi, and Philip loved the great feast of the church, and all day he heard people's confessions and compared them, and said, and now evening comes, time to die. He went to his room just after midnight on the 26th, he had an hemorrhage, and died shortly afterwards. So, here we are, celebrating our cheerful, joyful saint, and asking God to help us to have a little bit of his spirit as we try to love him. Thank you.
Thank you.